Hello my dear students, welcome again for the online classes. Today we will start with the same lesson, role of government in health. Till today we have studied about what is health, what is the actual meaning of the health. We always say that health is our wealth, means health is very important, and so government is taking lot of efforts to save the people, to save the people from the various diseases and the illness. Now the second point which we study is about the public healthcare and the private healthcare facilities. In public healthcare services, we have studied that the services which are for the people, which the government gives to the people, are called public healthcare services. And in private healthcare services, we saw that the doctors are running their own hospitals and they are providing the services at their private, in their private sectors. So this is about the public and the private sector. Nowadays the healthcare facilities are very inadequate. The public healthcare services are decreasing day by day, and the people are moving towards the private healthcare sectors. Why? Because the government is lacking behind to provide the proper healthcare services to the people, and people are spending lot of money to save their lives, to because they want to cure, because they want to live a happy and safe life, and so they are spending the money and taking the treatment from the private doctors. And so the private healthcare services are increasing day by day and public healthcare services are decreasing. Now as the government is not able to provide the proper healthcare services, the malpractices like corruption and so many things take place, people have to spend lot of money in the private hospitals, and because of this people have to sell their properties, people have to face lot of problems related to the money, because to pay the bills in the private hospital they have to sell their properties and all, they have to struggle a lot, and because of this day by day people are facing so many problems in their life. The poverty is increasing. So it is the duty of the government to provide the public services, because the people who are below the poverty line are getting the treatment in free in the government hospitals. So whatever services our government is providing, it is very necessary. So what can be done to improve the government services? So first of all, we have to improve the healthcare, public healthcare services. The public healthcare services means the government hospitals, the medicines, the laboratories, the government, all the facilities which government is providing has to be improved, so that the people can get the best service in their government hospitals. So whatever things take place in the middle, for example the corruption and malpractices, all these things should be stopped. And it is also very important that people should pay the taxes regularly, then only it is possible for the government to give the proper service. And also the second one is adequate medical facilities. Medicines and the medical equipments which are required in the laboratory should be adequate, then only it is possible for the government hospitals to provide to the people. That the health situation of most of the people in our country is not good, and the poor section of the society are facing lot of problem related to the health. In some of the parts even the women are not taken to the hospitals also. Why? Because the health of the woman woman is not given the importance. So it is the responsibility of the government to provide the quality healthcare services to all its citizens, especially the poor and the disadvantages. Now the government, why the government hospitals are made? So that the people who cannot afford the costly treatment, they can get the proper treatment and they can be cured. And so the healthcare services in the government hospitals is very, very necessary for the poor section of the country. Hence it is very important to improve the health situation of our people. If the health of the people is not given the importance, how we can have the development of our country? So the health of the people, that is from the lower section to the upper section, is very important, so that we can show the development in all the spheres of life. Our country can be a more and more developed country. When we will have the healthy people in our country, then only the people can show the development in the other spheres, and we can remove the complete poverty from our country. And when the poverty will be removed, our country will be well developed country. And so the health of a people is, health is given very, very important in the human life. And the second one, the examples given in our textbook is about the Kerala experience and the Costa Rican approach. Now through the Kerala experience, we can see that the Kerala government has given at the 40% of the entire state budget, it was given to the panchayat. Panchayat is the local government which works at the village level. And when these 40% of the fund was given to the panchayat, it was possible for the panchayat to work for the people. Means whatever things were needed for the people in the villages, construction of the roads, well, and also the facilities were made available in the government hospitals in the villages. And so through this way the Anganwadis, the working of the schools and the Anganwadis were also improved in the Kerala state. And Kerala has made a lot of efforts by providing the 40% of its total state budget. So through this experience, we can say that it is the responsibility of each and every state to give some of its fund to the panchayat, so that the panchayat will work from the lower level, so that we can see the development at the state level as early as possible. And the second example given here is about the Costa Rican. The Costa Rica is considered to be one of the healthiest country in Central America. The main reason is, this can be found in the Costa Rican constitution. Several years ago, Costa Rica took a very important decision and decided not to have any army. Now, why this decision was taken by this government? This helped the Costa Rican government to spend a money that the army would have used. So whatever money was used on the army was used for the welfare of the people. So these were the efforts taken by this country, and so it was one of the healthiest country in the Central America. So through these two examples, what can we say? That if the efforts will be taken by the state government, we can improve from the lower level to the higher level. So this is about what can be done for the adequate healthcare facilities. So today we have completed the lesson, that is the role of the government in the health. So this is about how the government plays the role, important role in the health of a people. What efforts government can take for the health, what efforts, how the government can provide the proper healthcare services, and along with the healthcare services, government can provide the clean drinking water and the construction of the roads. There are so many public services which are provided by the government. So for today, this much is enough. I will stop here. Read the lesson thoroughly and try to understand the concept. Thank you.